Welcome to the Getting Started with the AMD Kria K24 SOM and KD240 Drive Starter Kit demonstration. This demonstration is a brief introduction to the AMD Kria K24 System on Module and KD240 Drive Starter Kit. We'll talk about how to get started with the Drive Starter Kit, including flashing a prebuilt Ubuntu image onto a microSD card, making the necessary connections to the starter kit, and then booting Ubuntu on the starter kit. This demo requires the Kria KD240 Drive Starter Kit, which includes the K24 SOM, a carrier card, and a thermal solution to get started. Apart from this, the demo also requires the following additional hardware included with the kit: a power supply and adapter, a microSD card, Ethernet and microUSB to USB-A cables. System on modules, or SOMs, are becoming increasingly popular in the embedded systems domain. These compact, self-contained modules integrate essential components like a system-on-chip, SoC, memory, power management, and other supporting circuitry onto a single board. This makes them ideal for a wide range of applications requiring a small, pre-built platform with significant processing power. The AMD Kria K24 SOM is the newest addition to the AMD Kria portfolio of products. It is a compact, smaller form factor product that offers a faster path to volume production deployment compared to a chip-down approach. It also offers whole application acceleration at the edge and is optimized for power-efficient motor control and DSP applications. The AMD Kria K24 SOM integrates a custom-built AMD Zinc UltraScale Plus MPSoC optimized for the K24 SOM with LPDDR4 memory, non-volatile storage devices, a security module, and an aluminum thermal heat enclosure. It comes in commercial and industrial temperature grades built for volume edge deployment. The K24 SOM is designed to be plugged into a carrier card with solution-specific peripherals. Key target applications include motor control, industrial communications, and robotics, among many others. The K24 SOM empowers developers across diverse fields. Python developers can design with platform runtime orchestration using Python and leverage pre-built hardware libraries for a smooth development journey. AI developers can build custom AI inference applications and configure the AI processor to their specific requirements, tailoring the K24 SOM to their unique needs. Control system developers can leverage AMD Vitis Model Composer to simulate motor control and implement enhanced functionalities, optimizing performance for their control systems. Roboticists can develop robot behaviors via KRS, the Kria Robotics Stack, utilizing workspaces and a computational graph-centric approach for efficient robot programming. Software developers can accelerate the entire pipeline from software with the K24 SOM, which includes customized hardware acceleration using HLS, high-level synthesis. Hardware developers can enjoy great flexibility through full custom RTL design, allowing them to customize connectivity with catalog IP and tailor the hardware to their exact specifications. The K24 SOM provides many advantages over a chip-down design, including fast development time, affordable FPGA-based development platform for motor control applications, simplified inventory management, turnkey longevity and product lifecycle management, faster productization for high-volume deployment. AMD supports two ways to engage with Kria SOMs. The SOM can be mounted on an AMD-built carrier card just for evaluation and development purposes, or the SOM can be mounted on a simple carrier card designed by users that integrates into their embedded system. A user-designed card would mainly be used for production deployment. Let's now look at how to interact with the SOMs using an AMD-built carrier card, the Kria KD240 Drive Starter Kit. The AMD Kria KD240 Drive Starter Kit is comprised of a non-production version of the K24 SOM, a carrier card, and a thermal solution. The SOM is very compact and only includes key components, such as an AMD Zinc UltraScale Plus MPSoC-based silicon device, runtime memory, non-volatile boot devices, an integrated power solution, and a security module. The carrier card includes various application peripheral options, including motor control, USB, SD card, and Ethernet physical interfaces. The thermal solution has a passive heatsink. This Kria KD240 Drive Starter Kit is an evaluation platform for the K24 SOM focused on motor control and power conversion applications. It brings together a Zinc UltraScale Plus MPSoC-based SOM with pre-built application-specific peripherals and accelerated applications focused on motor control. The KD240 and its base K24 SOM are supported for full user customization through the AMD Vitis platforms, customizable acceleration overlays, and AMD Vivado Design Suite hardware board files. This integrated combination of hardware, platform, and software provides a quick out-of-the-box experience for developers that can then be leveraged for product designs. The Kria KD240 Drive Starter Kit includes the following accessories inside the box: power supply and adapters, an Ethernet cable, a USB-A male to micro-B cable, a microSD card with adapter, developer stickers, a Getting Started card that directs you to the Getting Started webpage and product page. Other highlights of this carrier card include a 12-volt power input jack, a microSD card slot for booting the device using an SD card, 3 GB Ethernet RJ45 interface ports, 2 USB 3.0/2.0 compatible interfaces, a 12-volt SOM fan power interface, PMOD expansion, an integrated JTAG and device UART interface via USB 2.0. A direct JTAG interface bypassing the FTDI device. A one-wire interface for one-wire-based sensors. A torque sensor connector. A brake control connector. A DC link power connector. A three-phase inverter connector for three-pole output. A quadrature encoder interface QEI connector with single-ended and differential encoder input, an RS-485 distributed serial bus connector to a PSMIO-based controller, a CAN connector connected to a PSMIO-based controller, a passive heatsink. Before you get started with the KD240 Starter Kit and run your first application, and even before you power and boot the board, you will need to download and flash the AMD Kria KD240 Drive Starter Kit Ubuntu image to a microSD card. At that point, you can then run a number of pre-built accelerated applications to start evaluation of the platform capabilities. Let's first look at how to flash the Ubuntu image onto the microSD card. Identify a compatible SDHC microSD card and insert the microSD card into your host machine. Download the Kria KD240 Drive Starter Kit image from the URL identified in the Kria SOM Getting Started guide. Flash the downloaded image onto the microSD card using one of the following tools. If you are working with Windows OS, you can use Win32 Disk Imager or Balena Etcher, which is recommended. If you are working with Linux OS, you can use the Linux DD tool. This demo uses the Balena Etcher utility, which is the recommended tool for writing the image onto a microSD card. It is available for Windows, Linux, and macOS. Download and install the Balena Etcher tool. Open the Balena Etcher tool and select the Flash from File option. Browse to the path where the Ubuntu image is kept and select the image. Note that the microSD card will be automatically detected. Click Flash to flash the image onto the microSD card. This may take about 2 to 3 minutes to complete. Once this is successful, remove the microSD card from your host machine and insert it into the KD240 Starter Kit microSD card slot at the J11 port. Now let's look at how to make all the necessary connections to the starter kit. Connect the KD240 drive starter kit to the 12-volt 3-amp power supply adapter at the DC barrel jack J12 port to power the kit. Do not insert the other end to the AC plug yet. Connect the Ethernet cable to the PSETH port, J24, for required internet access to download factory-loaded firmware. Take the USB-A to micro-B cable that supports data transfer and make the USB-based UART connection at the J4 port. Set up your USB-based UART connection with the following configuration using a serial terminal utility: TeraTerm for Windows and GTKTerm for Linux. This demo uses the GTKTerm serial terminal. Launch the terminal in the Linux OS. Open GTKTerm and select the enumerated serial port. Note that this kit uses an FTDI USB to COM port device that requires the FTDI virtual COM port driver to be installed on your host machine. Go to Configuration Port and set the following parameters. You should see 4 COM ports enumerated where the second numbered COM port corresponds to the UART. For Linux users, use the dmessage command in the terminal to determine the /dev/tty/usb port when you plug in the USB cable attached to the KD240 on your host machine. For Windows users, use the device manager to identify the COM port used when you plug in the USB cable attached to the KD240 on your host machine. Baud rate equals 115,200. Data bits equals 8, stop bits equals 1, flow control equals none, parity equals none. Power on the starter kit by connecting the power supply to the AC plug. The power LED should illuminate. The AMD Kria KD240 drive starter kit has primary and secondary boot devices that provide isolation of platform-specific boot firmware from the runtime operating system and application. This allows you to focus on developing and updating your application code within the application image without having to rebuild and flash boot firmware. The primary boot device is a QSPI memory located on the SOM, and the secondary boot device is an SD card interface on the carrier card. By default, the KD240 starter kit carrier card sets the XCK24 boot mode to QSPI 32. The SOM boots up to U-boot using the QSPI contents, and then U-boot does a handoff to the secondary boot device. After powering the starter kit on, Linux starts to boot, and you can see the log displayed on the serial terminal window. Observe the Linux UART response on the serial terminal program interface to see the log. If you see the heartbeat LED active but no UART response, verify that your machine has the FTDI driver installed and that the terminal program is connected to the correct COM port. At initial login, the Linux image will boot into the following login prompt. Note that the default username is Ubuntu and the password is Ubuntu in all lowercase characters. Once entered, the platform requires you to set a password. Make a note of the password you create for future use. Once Ubuntu has booted successfully, verify internet connectivity via ping or DNS lookup to check your network connectivity. The SOM Linux image provides a platform management utility called XMUtil to help you to configure and work with the SOM. You can use the -h or help functions with each utility for detailed use instructions. The table here lists the XMUtil commands and their options. For example, enter the sudo xmutil.h command to see more details about the XMUtil command. Note, to run a command in superuser mode like this, you will need to enter the password that you set earlier. The output of this command combination will allow you to see the different options that are supported by the XMUtil command. The KD240 platform is enabled with a number of accelerated applications which are software controllable and ready for execution on your target hardware. Each of the accelerated apps that are available from the Kria App Store can be dynamically installed on the SOM platform. Some of these featured accelerated applications available for the KD240 Starter Kit include the ROS2 Multi-Node Communications via TSN Accelerated Application, which focuses on applying ROS2 communications in the context of a time-sensitive networking, TSN-based communications infrastructure developed using the Kria Robotics Stack. The Field-Oriented Control, FOC, with Position Sensor Accelerated Application, which utilizes the Vitis Motor Control Library to offer deterministic and low-latency control of synchronous motors. The Vision AI DPU Pink Accelerated Application, which includes a Vitis AI DPU, Deep Learning Processor Unit, with AI inference notebooks ready to run out of the box. You will see how to run these accelerated applications using the Drive Starter Kit in the demo videos that follow. The key takeaways from this demo are: the AMD K24 SOM offers an excellent blend of features at an attractive price point. The AMD Kria KD240 Drive Starter Kit is designed for hardware, software, and AI developers without any prior FPGA expertise. Kria SOM platforms are enabled with a number of accelerated applications that can be dynamically installed. To summarize, in this demo you learned about the K24 SOM and its advantages, and the KD240 Drive Starter Kit and its features and interfaces. You also saw how to set up the microSD card, make connections to the kit, boot Linux on the starter kit, and explore the different pre-accelerated applications that it supports.